take your nebulizer and you set it up as if you would for a patient using a mouthpiece. Except once you get this on here, you're going to take a mask like from an ambu bag and you'll put it on like there. This way you'll be able to get a tight seal so that way that no aerosolized particles get out. You'll take one of these adapters, you'll place it on the other side, place your reservoir tubing on it, and then you'll put a bacteria filter.
Which is also a viral filter.
A viral filter. Here on the end of the reservoir tubing.
Okay.
So we're going to take the tourniquets and we're going to use those to create, to help hold the mask onto the patient's face. And so we have cut holes into the tourniquets that will attach here onto this plastic piece. Hold this up to your face, okay? So once the tourniquets are in place, it holds the mask onto the patient's face, creating a seal.
Inside the face mask is starting to smoke.
Take some slow deep breaths for me, okay? All the way in and then let it out. But it doesn't like any's getting out anywhere.
No.
From around up. You can feel them exhaling out here.
Yeah. So it's being filtered through this viral bacterial filter. Is this very uncomfortable? Does it feel okay? Feels okay? Okay. So he's getting this primarily, probably more for a cough variant asthma.
Okay.
And he's got a little minimal, but he's been doing a lot of coughing, right, Dad? This paroxysm of coughing so much that he vomits.
Yeah.
And maybe some allergies. It's the season.
Yeah.
But so when I listened to him, I didn't hear much in the way of wheezing, but he's got a prolonged expiratory phase. So I figured it wouldn't hurt to give this a try. Not too tight.
Doesn't feel too tight on your face?
So I think the good thing about this, it just basically prevents the aerosol from getting in the room. And I think it's much, much safer because that's what we're real concerned about.
Right.
And I think an adult or a kid this age could probably hold the mask on themselves.
Good, but this treatment's already going through, so we can go ahead and...
Yeah, let's do it. Let's try it. Let's just see how he does just holding it.
So we're going to put this up to your face. I want you to take your hands, put them on both sides of the mask, and I want you to hold it and try to push it tight up against your face, okay?
So that's good. So the patient's able to hold on to it. You'll feel gas coming out through here.
Mm-hmm. And you can even, when you breathe out, you can see it fill up in there with all of the aerosol.
Yeah. Do you have any trouble breathing in on it? Is there any difficulty? See it smoking out of there.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, put it back up over there. I think the big concern, like with COVID-19, is the aerosol coming out as the patient breathes.
Right.
So we basically have put an end to it by doing this.
I feel like this also has more uses in patients with TB or anything that's an aerosolized thing and you need to give them, for whatever reason, an aerosolized treatment. Having a setup like this just helps protect healthcare workers.
Yeah.